And what's up guys, this is my camera comparison test of the new Galaxy S22 Ultra versus the GoPro HERO 10 Black. Are GoPros going extinct? Do you even need it anymore? Are smartphones good enough? In today's video, we're gonna find out. This is the ultra wide lens on the S22 and this is super view on the GoPro. So can you see which one has that wider field of view? This is 4K 30 on each. Something you guys should notice throughout this video, the ultra wide lens on the S22 is just sort of disappointing. It's pixelated and soft. The GoPro's looking much sharper and wider angle. For another level of stabilization test, this is with horizon leveling turned on the GoPro. And this is with that super steady mode or whatever it's called on the S22. How do they look and compare?
GoPro's kind of racing ahead. That horizon leveling is pretty awesome and stable looking. The S22's capped at only 1080p in this mode. Plus it's much more narrow field of view and pretty wobbly compared to the GoPro. If you guys haven't seen my other GoPro videos this year, the gist of it is with this latest 10 Black, they've really stepped it up quite a bit.
Now let's do a little wind test. I'm racing along on the scooter. We're going about 20-ish here. How does the audio sound? This is audio on the S22.
Finally, we found a point that goes to the S22. It's audio sounding a tad cleaner and better wind reduction than the GoPro. I was pretty surprised with this one.
Now for max resolution, this is 5.3K on the GoPro and this is 8K 24fps on the S22. How do they look and compare? I know that GoPro is gonna have a much wider field of view, but the S22, we're cropping way in. And we're capped at only 24fps, no other options.
Let me state the obvious. With the GoPro, you're stuck with just one lens, ultra wide, and that's it. So let's say I wanna zoom in on those cool swans over there. Well, here's what it's gonna look like. It's just digital crop and it'll look pretty trashy. With the S22 Ultra, we've got like 100 lenses built into this thing. Check it out. We've got the ultra wide, which looks pretty good. Then we can switch to the 1X, then the 3x zoom, and then we've got a periscope 10X optical zoom. Super sweet. It's really sharp looking. We're still recording at 4K 30, and we can even do a little bit more of a digital crop in. Let's see, it goes up to 20x. Look at that, versus the GoPro. There's no competition for zoom. For mountability, of course the GoPro is gonna win. We have more versatile options with the mounting fingers and we can snap it onto here and onto here and all over the place. If I jump off an airplane, I'm using a GoPro, but with this cool phone adapter from Snap Mount, we still have some of that magnetic capabilities and you know, it's pretty good. You can even do hands-free POV shots if you wanted. I just wouldn't go racing off-road on a dirt bike anytime soon. Well, rocks are heavy. Now for one of my favorite tests, slow motion. On the GoPro, we can go up to 240fps at 2.7K. That's pretty good resolution and wide field of view. On the S22, we can burst up to 960fps, but the resolution, well, let's cannonball time. 3, 2, 1. I showed this in my last S22 Ultra versus iPhone 13 Pro camera test. Even though the 960fps burst is pretty low res at just 720p, it's still sort of fun to play with and it's just incredible how time almost looks like it's standing still with how slow motion it looks. However, that GoPro at 2.7K is pretty sharp looking.
And a neat trick with the S22, since it's such a quick burst and it's hard to time it right, you can turn on this auto motion detection mode, which is really cool. It worked out perfect for this rock.
The 4K 120 on the GoPro majorly destroys the S22 in standard slow motion mode. It's way wider angle and super sharp looking.
For durability, I think it'd be fine if I dropped the GoPro from way up here or higher. With the S22, this video is not sponsored by Samsung. I paid for the sucker myself. Next is hyperlapse mode. With the S22, we actually have a little bit of customization. We can go up to 4K. We can even change the speed ramp modes from auto, 5X, all the way up to 60, it's pretty nice. Then on the GoPro, on the much dimmer screen, as you can tell, we have a lot of good customization as well, 4K resolution. We can do auto speed, 5, 10, all the way up to 30.
This was another test that I was a little surprised with the results. I thought GoPro was gonna look way smoother over the S22. And even though it is, it's not as drastic of a stability difference as I thought. Now the GoPro, it clearly wins in other aspects as well, like wider angle, plus a much cleaner looking image. Do you guys guys see that heavy compression and grain on the S22 side? It's kind of janky. In low light 4K video, they both are tiny sensors and basically unusable footage here. It's crazy pixelated and dark, large noise and grain on the GoPro. When we look over at the computer screen, the GoPro looks a tad better, but then when I switch the S22 to its primary lens, which is gonna be a much higher quality lens and sensor, it sure cleans up quite a bit. Snapping some photos, this is one major area that the S22 will destroy the GoPro. My rule of thumb is do not ever get a GoPro for photography. A flagship phone like this S22 Ultra is gonna almost always win. The GoPro colors and contrast, they don't look terrible, and the S22, it's not perfect, but Samsung just has these nice vibrant HDR shots. They have insane amount of clarity and detail. And what's that, you wanna zoom in from a mile away and capture some wildlife and some swamps? The S22 Ultra can do that. If you're out exploring nature and you wanna play with macro photography, the S22 wins again. You want some fake shallow depth of field DSLR looking portrait shots? Well, the smartphone processing takes it. One unique win that actually goes over to the GoPro is low light photos. It's looking way better than those terrible S22 night mode shots on its ultra wide lens. I think Samsung should push out a software update here as soon as possible. Again, this is on the ultra wide lens. On the primary, it would look better.
If you're looking into one of these for vlogging, they both have pros and cons. With the GoPro, we have a front facing selfie screen and it looks okay, it's just a little small. With the S22, well, you'd wanna flip around to use the selfie camera and you have a much bigger screen and all your controls and touchscreen, which is really nice. However, that lens up on the front is not as good as the rear primaries. For remote shutter options, we can say, hey GoPro, take a photo. And it does a pretty good job. On Samsung, we have a stylus. We can just press the button and it can do remote shots as well. Start and stop recording. It's nice to have options on each. Whether you guys are a content creator like me or a parent capturing weekend adventures and memories of your kids with your GoPro or your smartphone, we wanna share those memories right away on our socials. With the phone, it's easy. You just beep, pop, and it's posted. With the GoPro, we have to connect over via Wi-Fi, copy the clips, edit, trim, post. It's such a hassle. How many times do clips go unused on the GoPro? I know it happens a lot.
So personally, I don't think GoPros are going extinct just yet, but these flagship phones just have so much versatility with their camera systems. They can do so much for the average shooter. And for some people out there, maybe you can save some money and not buy the latest action camera and maybe just upgrade to a flagship phone. Something to think about. If you guys want to see how the GoPro 10 stacked up against the latest iPhone 13 Pro, check that video out next. It was really interesting. I'll also link my other GoPro 10 videos down below. Thanks guys, and I'll see you in the next one.